Hello everyone, I hope everyone is healthy. We obviously don't have face-to-face lectures anymore, and some of you have reached out and pointed out that there are some aspects of the normal face-to-face instruction that you find helpful, and particularly these are the tangents or like historical background information that sometimes we go into, and they somehow help retain the information. And as you know, well, this is a CFD course and fluid mechanics is a dry subject, as we know. And right now in particular, we are in the midst of a topic that is heavy on tedious derivations and not much exciting examples. So I thought that I would like to provide some entertainment, hopefully that would be helpful, but just recording audio would be somehow too sad. So I thought I'll show some of the fun facts that I found as we were covering this methods. So without further ado, we've been discussing, well, not really discussing, but virtually, through the lecture notes, the McCormick method. It's a very elegant discretization method for hyperbolic PDEs, partial differential equations. It was developed by Robert McCormick, who is a professor emeritus at Stanford. He has many honors and prestigious awards, and he developed it when he was at NASA Ames Research Center in the 1960s. And this was a fascinating time for CFD development, because those are relatively early days of electronic computing, but already some substantial computing power was emerging. And at that time, NASA was working on Project Mercury, which is the human spaceflight project. And one of the critical issues there, the problems that they were trying to solve, was thermal management of the spacecraft during the re-entry to atmosphere. And that involves supersonic flows over blunt nose bodies that are described by actually hyperbolic equations. So this is a photograph, this is an experimental image, a shadow graph of a re-entry shock wave that's produced around the capsule model. And this, by the way, the image is created by the, it's a shadow created by density gradients in the flow. By the way, the images here are from Wikipedia, so please take them with that reference. So at the beginning of that transitional period for the CFD, NASA Ames Center had actually IBM 7090 or 7094 computers that were built in the 1960s. Here is the operator's console in 1961, and this is the actual computers in the NASA Ames Center at work. Computers were inadequate, and thus the methods that were developed at that time for viscous flows, for gas dynamics, they had to be clean and elegant and easy to implement. So, by the way, these computers, the fun fact about that is that a typical system, this IBM 7090, in the 1960, it was sold for $2.9 million, which is equivalent to $19 million in 2019. Or it could be rented much cheaply, much more, more effectively, I guess, for about $63,500 per month, which is equivalent to $421,000 in 2018. So it's about the price of a two-bedroom condo in Victoria right now. Oh, and by the way, as to what costs $19 million now, did a quick search just because it's a fun thing to do. And it's apparently one of the things you can buy for an equivalent amount of money. It's Bugatti's La Voiture Noire, which is just a black car. It's the prices including taxes, but of course given the choice we would all buy a computer to do CFD. And by the way, later in the 1970s, NASA Ames Center acquired the ILIAC 4 computer, which was really a milestone for CFD because it was the first massively parallel computer. It was actually designed to have 4 CPUs, each capable of 1 billion operations per second, but due to some constraints, primarily budget, I understand, it was only a one single CPU version that was built. So these are some images. This is the processing unit and how it was wired. So everything was nicely laid out, as you can see. These are some fun aspects related to McCormick method. I thought that if we could provide some fun for that, that probably would make this dry material a little bit more palatable. So, all right, take care. I'll see you later.